David Ruffin.
He's alive. He's alive.
Here we are. Here we are. Amen. Amen. We are here by the grace of God. Amen. Let us give God some praise wherever you are. Amen. We're thankful. We're thankful and grateful that we are here this morning. Amen. I know it's been a minute since Pastor has been here, but we are here. We are here by the grace of God. And I'm just so thankful. I'm elated. Amen. To be back here in this place once again. Amen. I hope that you are comfortable, amen, wherever you are. I hope that you're preparing your mind and your heart, amen, getting ready to receive the word of God, amen. It's the word of God that is able to inspire, that is able to uplift you, amen, that is able, amen, to save you, amen. We're thankful that we have a few of our choir members here this morning, our media team, our musicians, our trustee ministry, our deacon ministry. We're just so elated that we're able to come back together again. Amen. Few in numbers. Amen. But we still have the love of God in our hearts wherever you are. Amen. While we still can't have church traditionally, we can still be the church consistently. It's still the same message. Somebody says still the same message. It's a new platform, but it's still same power. A new season, guess what? Same God, amen. Just like now, it's a new year, 2021. But God is still the same. He's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. Amen. To God be the glory. We're not going to prolong the time. We're going to have our prayer. It's going to be done by Deacon Peabody. We're going to ask him to come now and render prayer for us. Amen.
Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we come to you one more time. Oh Lord, we come to you with a heart full of thanksgiving. And oh Lord, we come to you with praise on our mind. Oh Lord, come to you this morning. Thank you for the many blessings you restored upon us.
Yes.
Not because we've been so holy, because your grace and mercy have brought us this far. Oh Lord, thank you for letting us have food on our table. And, oh, Lord, to have clothes on our back.
Yes.
And, oh, Lord, we just want to thank you for letting us be in the wood and living for one more time. Oh, Lord, we could have been dead and sleeping in our grave. Oh, Lord, you seem fit to let us wake up and start another day that we never have to live. And, oh, Lord, to be down, Holy Spirit, we ask you to just bless us this morning. Oh, Lord, bless us in your mighty way this morning. And, oh, Lord, we ask you to bless us. Bless Miley about the church. And oh Lord, we ask you to bless the pastor of this church. Oh Lord, we go, ask you to go with him and stand by him and don't leave him alone. And oh Lord, we ask you to build him up where he's torn down. And oh Lord, strengthen where he's weak. And oh Lord, just have mercy on him this morning as he stand and bring the message. And oh Lord, we ask you to bless churches all over this land that are open in your name this morning. Oh Lord, we ask you to go with him and stand by him and don't leave him alone. And oh Lord, we ask you to have mercy upon this world. And oh Lord, we ask you to have mercy upon the United States.
Yes.
Oh Lord, we have death on every hand.
Yes.
Oh Lord, we have violence on every hand.
Yes.
Oh Lord, we have politics trouble on every hand.
Yes.
Oh Lord, we ask you to just come down this morning.
Yes.
And show your love and grace this morning.
Yes.
Oh Lord, just have mercy upon us.
Yes.
Oh Lord, we need you this morning. Oh Lord, we need you for one thing, and oh Lord, we need you for another. Oh Lord, we need you for our sister, and we need you for our brother.
Yes.
Oh Lord, we ask you to come with us, stand by us, and don't leave us alone. And oh Lord, to be down, holy will. We ask you to bless the sick this morning.
Yes.
And oh Lord, we ask you to bless the prison bound this morning.
Yes.
And oh Lord, we ask you to bereave family all over this land. And oh Lord, be down, holy will.
Yes.
We ask you to bless Deacon Murphy in the passing of his mother this morning. Oh Lord, we ask you to strengthen where he's weak and turn him up where he's torn down. And oh Lord, just have mercy upon us. Oh Lord, mercy was through our need this morning. Oh Lord, we ask you to go with us and stand by us and don't leave us alone. And oh Lord, when we come down to the end of our journey. Oh Lord, we'll move in the room to study one no more. And oh Lord, when we lay down to him, books in the Bible.
Yes, Lord.
Oh Lord, we ask you to give us a home somewhere in your kingdom. In the mighty name of Jesus, in the holy name of Jesus, we do pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Yeah.
Amen.
Amen. And
amen. 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 We thank God. Amen. Thank God. Amen. Thank you, Deke, for that fervent prayer. Amen. You know, prayer is in order. Amen. We do stand in need of prayer. Amen. I'm going to get out of the way and allow this male chorus, a portion of them, to come with us and give us a selection. Amen. This time. Come on, guys.
Shepherd, I shall not want.
Lord is my shepherd,
I shall not want.
Lord is my shepherd,
I shall not want.
Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Lord is my shepherd,
I shall not want.
Lord is my shepherd,
I shall not want.
Lord is my shepherd,
I shall not want.
Oh,
Lord is my shepherd.
shall not want.
Make me lie down in green pastures.
I shall not want.
He making me lie down in green pastures.
I shall not want.
Oh Lord,
the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want.
Lord,
I shall not want.
Make me lie down in green pastures.
I shall not want.
He make me lie down in green.
I shall not want.
Oh Lord,
the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want.
Lord is my shepherd.
I shall not want.
Lord is my shepherd.
I shall not want.
Lord is my shepherd.
I shall not want.
Yeah.
Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want.
Let me say it again. Lord is my shepherd,
I shall not want.
Lord is my shepherd,
I shall not want.
Lord is my shepherd,
I shall not want.
Yeah.
Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. I shall not want.
I shall
not want.
I shall not want. Jesus, you promised me.
I shall not want.
Whatever I need.
I shall not want.
Whatever I ask for.
I shall not want.
You will supply.
I shall not want.
All my needs.
I shall not want.
And I'm trusting you.
I shall not want.
I'm trusting you.
I shall not want.
Trust in you,
I shall
Jesus.
Not want.
I shall not.
I shall not want.
I shall not want. Heal this land.
I shall not want.
Heal the sickness.
I shall not want.
Yeah, Lord.
I shall not want.
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 I shall not want. He making me.
I shall not want.
Lie down in green pastures.
I shall not want.
I shall not want.
I shall not want.
I'd wonder if I could give one witness.
I shall not want.
Charge, why don't you help me?
I shall not want.
When you woke me up.
I shall not want.
Early this morning.
I shall not want.
Start
me. I shall not want.
On my way.
I shall not want.
I had my
girl. I shall not want.
Help me.
I shall not want. I shall not want.
I had food on.
I shall not want.
Clothes on my back.
I shall not want.
I shall not.
I shall not want.
He gave me life.
I shall not want.
That I may.
Oh, I shall not want.
I wonder about you.
I shall not want.
Will you live in?
I shall not want.
Oh,
I shall not want. I shall not want. I shall not want. I shall not want. I shall not want.
Good God,
I shall not want.
When he died,
I shall not want.
On Calvary,
I shall not want.
You should not want.
I shall not want.
When he died,
I shall not want.
When he said,
I shall not want.
I don't care.
I shall not want.
You shall not.
I shall not want.
Shall not want.
I shall not want.
Jesus.
I shall not want.
When he laid him down.
I shall not want.
In that bar.
I shall not want.
I shall not want.
Shall not want. I shall not want. Everybody. I shall not want.
On the sound of my voice.
I shall not want.
Shall not.
I shall not want.
I shall not want. The Lord is my shepherd.
I shall not want.
Lord is my shepherd.
I shall not want.
Lord is my shepherd.
I shall not want.
Yeah.
Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want.
The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. Amen. He promised to supply all of my needs according to his riches and glory. Amen. I don't have to want for anything because God, he has promised to supply it for me and to me. Amen. Thank you. Thank you, Mayor Kors. Thank you. Thank you. Amen. Superior job. Amen. I have a few announcements I want to give to you. We want to be in prayer for the Murphy and the Weeks family. Deacon Raymond Murphy, his mother transitioned on last week. Amen. Definitely want to be in prayer for them. And Bible study will resume February the 3rd at 6 o'clock. February the 3rd at 6 o'clock. Amen. All right. And if everything goes according to plan, we will have a food drive for Mount Olive Missionary Baptist Church only. Won't be for the community just yet. We're going to do it for the church only. And if all goes according to plan, that would be January the 28th this month. January the 28th. We hadn't decided on the time, but I'll give you the time next week. The Lord said the same. So it'll be for Mount Olive Church family only. Let us not forget, on tomorrow, January the 18th, it'll be Martin Luther King Jr. Day. And so let us remember what Dr. King did as a civil rights leader, as a nonviolent protester as it relates for we as a black people. Amen. And just for the nation at large. And so we just want to remember him. Amen. And I got word that today is Brother Jeremy Upshaw, his 50th birthday today. Today he's 50 years old today. All right, man. I remember when I was 50. Amen. You heard that, didn't you? I remember when I was 50. Amen. Amen. Grace be unto God. So, and there again, we will be starting 2021. With online birthday acknowledgments beginning next Sunday. If you would like to see your birthday picture on the screen, please submit birthday pictures each Saturday. Amen. Please respect the deadline. Media team, amen. They giving it to you just like it is. Please respect the deadline. So if you want to see your picture, amen, on the screen, do that. Amen. Submit your picture. And you can reach out to Sister Keisha Jacobs via text, messenger, or call. Amen. In that order. So let's do that if you want to see your picture on the screen. Amen. Each Sunday, whatever month it is, whatever month it falls in, let's get your picture to her. Amen. Amen. And not only Brother Jeremy, my wife, the apple of my eye, her birthday is this month as well. I'll toot the horn for you, sweetheart. I know you're at home watching. Her birthday is this month as well. So we just thank God for all of you who are having birthdays, and God has really blessed your life, and he's really moving in your life, and he's allowed your golden moments to roll on a little while longer. And so we just want to give God praise for that. Amen. Amen. Most definitely, we want to continue to pray for all of our sick and all of our shut-ins. Amen? Amen. Let us continue to do that. All right, I'm going to move out of the way and allow this mail course to come back with another selection. Amen. They're doing a superior job this morning. I just praise God. Come on. Come on, God.
Good morning, Mount Olive. Via Facebook and social media. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. I feel pretty good this morning, Mount Olive.
All right.
We some blessed folks, you know. Pandemic is all around us and God is still keeping us. Young folk, you're really blessed. I've seen little bitty babies with $40 and $50 tennis shoes on.
Yes, sir.
Can't even walk.
Amen.
We're blessed.
Yes, sir.
Let me tell you something. A little bit about me, sir. Hold on, fellas. I didn't have no money. A lot of my friends, thought it was funny. So glad today.
Come on, son.
How many of you glad,
yes, sir,
that I can stand right here and say, can I get a witness,
yes, sir,
that the Lord been good, sure been good to me, y'all. Lord, I'm just standing here looking over my life, y'all. Let me take inventory. Can I take it? Cause I know you, I know you, I know you've been good to me, Lord. Now those of you out there who like me, and you know you come from a poor family, come on and put your hands together and help us this morning. From a poor family, we didn't have much, but the Lord been good to me. Come from a poor family, we didn't have much, but the Lord been good to me. Come from a poor family, we didn't have much, but the Lord been good to me. Listen. I didn't have no money. A lot of my friends thought it was funny. But I'm so glad today that I can stand right here and say that the Lord been good to me. Somebody out there, you can say this. You were raised in a shack, y'all. Sometimes clothes were thin that you put on your back. Mom and daddy, they done the best they could. They always told you, child, always be good. But out of all the things, hey, I know that the Lord been good to me. Oh, been good,
been good.
Ain't God good?
He been good to me.
Been good,
he been good.
Ain't God good?
He been.
How many know he got power?
He's been good.
How many know he got power?
He's been good.
How many know he's got power?
He's been good.
Yes, he has.
He's been good.
He blessed me.
He's been good.
Yes, he did, y'all.
He's been good.
He blessed me.
He's been good.
Oh, yes, he did. There have been times
he's
in my life.
Good.
Oh, help me, Lord. Seems like every
he's
time that I got a nickel, I had to spend the dime. But let me ask y'all something. Can I ask y'all something? I want to ask you something. Anybody know I'm as a rock? rocking a weary land. Anybody know him as Brad? Brad in a starving land. I wonder, can I get one witness? Wonder, can I get one witness?
Yeah.
I don't mean to be nosy, but have they been good to you? Have they been good to you? I got one more question. I got one more question. Can I ask you one question? Anybody got the Holy Ghost?
Holy Ghost.
Anybody got the Holy Ghost?
Holy Ghost.
Anybody got the Holy Ghost?
Holy Ghost.
Yeah. Holy Ghost.
Wow.
Holy Ghost.
Wow.
Holy Ghost.
Wow.
Walking that.
Wow.
Talking that.
Wow.
Living that.
Wow.
Holy Ghost.
Wow.
Got to have it.
Wow.
Can you get it?
Wow.
Can you get it?
Wow.
I gotta have it.
Wow.
I need it.
Wow.
Holy Ghost.
Wow.
Holy Ghost.
Wow.
Holy Ghost.
Wow.
Yeah. Holy Ghost.
Wow.
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 Holy Ghost. Wow. Hey, listen. Out of all the things that I've done in life, I know that the Lord been good to me, y'all. Is that all right?
Yeah.
Is that all right?
Yeah.
Can I tell you one more thing?
Tell it.
Sometimes I get by myself and I tell the Lord.
Yeah.
I may not drive a Maserati, but I thank him for the little car he gave me. May not live in a mansion on a hill, but I thank him for the house he blessed me with. Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Anybody knowing this morning? He's been good.
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 He's been good to me.
Can I tell y'all?
He's been good to me.
Can I tell y'all?
He's been good.
How good God has been.
He's been good.
Can I tell you how good?
He's been good.
Clothes on my back.
He's been good.
Shoes on my feet.
He's been good.
Food on my table.
He's been good.
I know God is able.
He's been good.
Ain't he all right?
He's been good.
Ain't he all right?
He's been good.
Whoa. He's been good.
He's been good.
He's been good.
He's been good.
He's been better than good.
He's been good.
He's been better than good.
He's been good.
Chill.
He's been good.
Chill.
He's been good.
This morning. Yes.
Jesus.
That's what we're talking about.
Jesus.
That's what we're talking about, Jeff.
Yes.
Jesus. Come on.
Jesus.
Yes, what is it? If you're a rock in a weary land, come on and help. Come on and help. Tell me what is it?
What is Jesus? Is he a rock in a river land? Jesus.
Yeah.
Can I tell you about Jesus?
Yeah.
Rock in a weary land.
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 In the time of a storm.
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 Yeah. In a lonely hour.
In a lonely hour.
In a lonely hour.
Yeah.
Oh, that's Jesus.
Yeah.
Oh, that's Jesus.
Jesus.
But most of all,
yeah.
He's my Savior.
Yeah.
He's my way.
Yes, sir.
When my way get dark, he's a bridge.
Yeah.
Over troubled water. Jesus. Jesus.
Jesus.
Out of all the things that I've done in life, I know that the Lord, he's good to me, y'all.
Yes, Lord. Oh, yeah. Yes, sir. Yeah. Yeah.
I don't want to do too much too soon. Amen. 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 But I just have to be a witness to that. We're talking about Jesus and the Holy Ghost. Amen. Holy Ghost power. It's something about the Holy Spirit. Father, we come now. We thank you for your presence. Thank you for your power. Thank you for being our guest of honor this morning. And we just want to give you honest and sincere praise. Thank you, God, for the anointing. Thank you for your power. Thank you, God, for what you're doing through us. We'll be careful to give you the praise, the honor, and the glory. For you're worthy of it all, Father. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 For a few moments, I want to call your attention to the Gospel of Matthew. The Gospel of Matthew. The Gospel of Matthew. Chapter 6. The Gospel of Matthew, chapter 6. Amen. Verse 33. We're going to talk about a little bit just what you was singing about. Amen. The Gospel of Matthew, chapter 6, verse 33. Very familiar passage of scripture. But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Amen. 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 That's what Jesus said. Jesus said that if Jesus said it, you ought to pay attention to it and believe it. Amen? Amen. We want to talk about for a few moments, if you don't mind, seeking God more in 2021. Amen. Seeking more of God in 2021. Here it is, my brothers and sisters. It is Jesus now. He's teaching and he's talking to his disciples about on setting priorities, putting first things first. Have I got a witness here?
Amen.
And so really everything rises and falls right here. If your priorities are not in order, your life will not be in order. I think I need to say that again. If your priorities are not right or in order, your life will not be in order. So if your priorities are not right, you won't be right. Ought to have a witness here. You won't be right. You don't have to pray about what your number one priority in life ought to be. You don't have to think about it. You don't have to discuss it. You don't have to look for it, because your first priority ought to be seeking Jesus. Have I got a witness here? Because Jesus has already told us what our first priority ought to be. And what does he say? He says, seek ye first the kingdom of God. And that word means to actively. If you're seeking, that means you're actively in pursuit of God. In other words, you're going after God. You're not being complacent. You're not being at a standstill. You're going after, because you're in hot pursuit of the Lord. It's in present tense. It means continuously. You don't do it one day and then forget about it the next day. Have I got a witness here? It's continuously. Every day of your life, you ought to seek the kingdom of God. Now, in order to seek the kingdom, you first must seek the king, because every kingdom has a king. Amen. Have I got a witness here?
Yes, sir.
Because you cannot have a kingdom without a king. And so the first priority of your life ought to be to seek the king of the kingdom. Have I got me a witness? Do you know that the Christian life is more than just accepting the Lord? It's seeking the Lord. The Lord is not just someone you passively accept. Let me say that again. The Lord is not someone you just passively accept. He is someone you actively seek. In other words, you go after him. See, I can tell a lot about people, and you can too. About their relationship. Whenever you meet them, you can tell what kind of relationship they have with the Lord. Have I got a witness here? Because God does give you the discerning of spirit. And after all, once they open their mouth, you'll be able to tell something sort of what their relationship is with the Lord. And so, but it's not enough just to seek the Lord. You must seek him first. Yes, Jesus said. But he also said, seek first the kingdom of God. Meaning, putting the Father first. Say that with me out there. Putting the Father first. See, that's what you got to do. You got to put him first in your life. And a lot of times, I've been there. I've made the wrong choices in life. And I omitted to seek Jesus. I omitted to do the things that he have called me to do and be. Yes, I've been there. Did that, done that, got T-shirt. But time comes along to where, especially when you get a little older. See, the older you get, you ought to get a little wiser. And the wiser you get, you ought to see that the most important things in life is heavenly. See, we're working for the heavenly things. You don't need to set your affections on things down here, because these things are just temporary. Everything down here diminishes. It rots. It molds. It goes away. It disappears. So if we set our affections on things which are above, which is heavenly, then we'll be in the right place. Jesus wants the first moments of every day. Jesus wants the first day of every week. And I think I'm going to make somebody mad right here, because Jesus, if you don't believe me, Jesus wants the first part of every paycheck. Oh, man, I didn't get no amens on that. Yeah, he wants the first part of every paycheck. Oh, yes, my brothers and sisters, but not only are we to seek the king, we ought to seek the kingdom. Because the kingdom of God ought to be the obsession of your life. It ought to be first in your life. You ought to have that desire. You ought to be on fire every day to get closer to God. Every day you ought to be trying to get a little closer to God. Because after all, when you think about his goodness and all that he's done for you, amen, your soul ought to cry out hallelujah. Oh, yes, my brothers and sisters, the word kingdom here literally means rule or reign. And a kingdom is a place where a king rules. And so to seek the kingdom of God is to seek the rulership of God. In other words, if God is going to be Lord of our lives, he needs to be Lord of our finances. We need to make him Lord over our families, over our decision making. All of that, not just one thing, but everything. We're going to make him Lord of our lives, and we're asking him to rule our lives, then we must include him in every aspect of our lives. Have I got a witness here? Amen. Oh, yes, my brothers and sisters, if you're seeking God, you have to seek the glory of the king. Every part and parcel of your life, every minute, every moment of your time, every ounce, every pound of your strength, ought to be in seeking God. Every muscle and fiber of your body ought to be given for the glory of God. Whether therefore ye eat or drink or whatsoever ye do, do all to the glory of God. Have I got a witness here?
Amen.
In other words, what matters most is what you put out to God. So whether you're eating, whether you're socializing, whatever it is, you ought to put God first in it all. That's what he's saying. That's what Paul said. 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 31. Whether therefore you eat, drink, whatsoever ye do, do it all to the glory of God. And so, my brothers and sisters, if we're going to seek the glory of God and his guidance, we have to seek the king, and we have to be loyal. A loyal subject always wants to do whatever the king would have him to do. There's no higher calling in life than to find out what your king wants done. And then do it.
Yes, sir.
It's one thing to talk to God and say, Lord, what is it that you would have me to do in life? What is it, Lord, where you would have me to go and be in life? But once God tells you the answer and he gives you the answer, our response should be is to do it. Have I got a witness here? Oh, yes, my brothers and sisters, every moment of your life, you ought to be asking the Lord Jesus. That's what Paul asked the Lord Jesus on the Damascus Road. When he said, Lord, what will you have me to do? And all of us ought to be asking God that. Lord, what is it that you would have me to do? What is your will for my life? Lord, where are you leading me? Where are you guiding me, Lord? Lord, here I am. Use me. I am your loyal subject. And once you put it all in God's hand, God will. He will reveal unto you. Yeah, what he wants you to do. And so that was in Jesus' day, the disciples, they was more concerned about their finance, about clothing. They was concerned about everything else except seeking God. Have I got a witness here?
Amen.
And I like what verse 19 says of chapter 6. It says, lay not up yourselves treasures upon earth where moth and rust doth corrupt and where thieves break in through and steal. In other words, my brothers and sisters, don't worry about laying up treasures here on earth, because there's one or two things about it. We're going to leave it, or it leaves us. Have I got a witness here? But what we got to do, we got to find ourselves seeking the Lord. Because he thus says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. I like that about God. He says, seek his righteousness. Because after all of our righteousness is just like a filthy rag. And so if we seek the righteousness of God, we will be in order. Oh yes, my brothers and sisters, then he goes on to say, and all these things shall be added unto you. That's why he says, don't take no thought for your life. Don't worry about it, because even if the fowls of the air, for they sow not, neither do they reap, nor gather into barns, yet your heavenly Father feedeth them. Are you not much better than these? So our heavenly Father already knows your rent is due. Our heavenly Father knows what you have need of. He already knows that you have need of food and clothing. Have I got a witness here? You ought to get happy about that, that the God of the universe, the one who made the stars and the moon and the sun, he already knows about what you have need of. And so you don't have to go around worrying about that, your finance, about this, that, and the other. But what you have to do, you have to set boundaries. And you have to be a good steward over what he gives you. Oh, yes, my brothers and sisters, so many times I've been there, yes. I've taken the rent money, knowing it was for my rent, and I did something else with it. Yes, have I got a witness here? Amen. Oh, yes, you got to prioritize. Rent money is just what it is. Yes, yes, your food, your money for food and groceries is just what it is. Yes, your clothing, yes. You know what you want to buy is just what it is, but you can't take and mismanage what God has given you. You have to become a good steward over what God has given you. Have I got a witness here? Oh, yes, that's why he said all these things shall be added unto you. Have I got me a witness here? Oh, yes, my brothers and sisters, in 2021, that ought to be all of our desires. It ought to be to seek God more. We ought to get it up in our mind, in our spirit, in our hearts, that yes, I need Jesus. Oh yes, and you going around worrying about what sister so-and-so got and brother so-and-so got, trying to keep up with the Joneses. Yes, you just be content of what you have. Oh yes, and if you have a little money in the bank, that's good. But yes, my brothers and sisters, don't go too far. Because I've seen a lot of people that say, yes, I got a whole lot of money in the bank. But yes, but they had no relationship with God. Have I got me a witness here? Oh yeah, that's why God can't bless a whole lot of people with a whole lot of things. Because they allowed the things to separate themselves from the love of God and others. Have I got me a witness here? Oh yes, my brothers and sisters, I want you to know today that this is a personal thing. You have to do it for yourself. If you want the Lord, and seek him more in 2021, you got to go down on your knees and you got to be honest with God. And say, Lord, here I am. I'm seeking you, Jesus. Oh yes, I admit in 2020, oh yes, I did some things that I shouldn't have done. And I said some things I shouldn't have said. My Lord, and gone some places I shouldn't have gone. But here I am, Jesus. I'm standing in the need of prayer. My God, and here I am, Lord. I'm ready now to surrender myself unto you. In other words, you got to say, Lord, hear my hands. Use them like you want to use them. And Lord, here's my heart. I want to love the way you want me to love. Here I am, Jesus, calling on your holy and righteous name. Can I give me a witness here? Jesus said, don't worry about the things of life. Have I got a witness here? If the bird is able to fly around, and he don't have to work or toil for it, and I take care of the little bird, have I got a witness here? His eyes is on the sparrow, and I know, yeah, he watches over me. Have I got a witness here? I'm so glad today, yeah, that I serve a God who sits high and then looks low. Have I got a witness here? My desire this year is to get more of God in my life. I want to love more. I want to give more. I want to walk right more. Y'all don't hear me. I want to serve more, because after all, if it had not been for the Lord, for him on my side, where would I be? Y'all don't hear me. I've been sick as sick could be, but I know it was nobody but the Lord who raised me up, turn me around, and I'm here today to give him some praise. Jesus, I just want to give him some praise. Jesus, good God Almighty here. Jesus. One Friday evening, he came and died for me and you. But what I love about it, Jasper, it early, that Thursday morning, got up out of a dusty grave. Oh, power! It is in! Woo! Said I wasn't going to do too much too soon.
All right.
But I did preach Jesus.
Yes,
have I got a witness here?
Amen.
So if that's you this morning who have made a New Year resolution, you said to yourself that you want to do this and you plan to do that and you plan to go here, how about making Jesus your first priority? How about telling God, Lord, I want to be more like you. Lord, I want to be used of you. Here's my hand. Here's my heart. Here's my mind, Lord. I want to be used of you. That's what you got to do. Let's try doing that in 2021. Seeking more of God. Seeking more of God. The door of the church is open. We're going to go back a little bit. We're going to go back a little bit for you. And it may be a little old school for some of you all. Yeah. But this was mama and grandmama. This what they was brought on, brought up on. Yeah. Let's sing this, guys.
We are climbing Jacob's ladder. We are climbing Jacob's ladder. We are climbing Jacob's ladder. Soldier of the Lord.
Can y'all help me say that, y'all? Let's do that.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, we are climbing.
We are,
yeah, that's it.
Climbing.
Yeah, sound good to me.
Jacob's ladder.
Oh, we are.
We are
climbing.
Climbing.
Yeah.
Jacob. Ladder.
That's grandmama there.
We are climbing Jacob's ladder. Soldier of the.
Yeah. And then one of those mothers would break out and say this. Every round goes higher and higher. Come on, guys.
Every,
yeah, that's it.
Round goes higher.
I can hear Big Mama and Grandmama. I can hear Mama them saying that.
Every.
Soldier of the, yeah.
Cross.
And then they would break out and say this.
Rise and shine. Give God the glory.
Come on, guys.
Rise.
Yeah.
Shine.
That's it.
Mama
will ask this question. They said it.
Do you think I'll make a soldier? Do you?
What about you?
Think I'll make a,
yeah,
soldier?
Can't you hear him saying that?
Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord.
Yes, my Lord.
Oh, yeah. My.
Woo.
Amen. Seeking more of God in 2021. That ought to be your New Year resolution. You want to get more love in your heart. You want to be more faithful unto God. You want to be more serving towards God and your fellow man. Amen. Because that's what it's all about. Amen. To God be the glory. Amen. Let me tell you this right quick. I know what we have been watching on the TV in the last week or so as it relates to all of this chaos going on. But be not dismayed. Whatever betides you, God will take care of you. Amen. It's not so much as about of what you can see, but it's about your faith in God. God, he has the last say so. Amen. God is going to take care of everything. But what you have to do, you have to continue to walk to walk and talk to talk. Continue to trust in the Lord. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not to your own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he will what? direct your path. Amen. So that's what we got to do. Amen. So I hope I have said something. Hope that the male chorus have sang something to inspire you and to uplift you on today. And I want to tell you, Mount Olive, thank you again. Thank you, thank you, thank you. First Lady sends her love. Can't thank you enough for what you did while we was away. And she sends her love. So does my mother. She sends her love as well. Amen. She's so crazy about you, Mount Olive. Amen. She always tell me, son, when how your church family doing? But tell them I love them. Amen. I said, all right. So, Mama, I know you're watching. And I know Mount Olive, you're listening. My mama says she love y'all. Amen. To God be the glory. All right. So that's all we have today. I want to thank the musicians. Thank this mayor, of course. Amen. Continue to pray for the ones that whom you know have been have contracted the virus directly or indirectly. Continue to pray one for another. Amen. Amen. All right. Let us pray. Father, we come now to the end of this worship. God, we thank you now for your presence and your power. Pray, God, those that have been watching and those that have been listening by conference call, pray, God, that their lives have been impacted by this word of what you have told us, oh God. We got to seek more of you, God. Don't worry about the things of life because you promised to supply all of our needs according to your riches and glory. And we just want to give you praise. We thank you right now. Now may the grace of God and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide be with you all henceforth and forever. Let us all say amen, amen, and hallelujah. Go in peace. We love you.
Had to cry. Daddy, y'all.